Thank you for joining us today on another installment of Frost & Sullivan's exciting podcast series, highlighting key disruptive technologies, growth opportunities, economic trends, new business models, industry convergence, emerging geographies, and much more. I'm Deepak Jayakumar, Senior Research Analyst with the TechVision team, and I will be providing you a brief insight about our recent research on breakthrough treatments for non-alcoholic steatohepatitis, otherwise known as NASH. This global research service provides information about industry trends, IP landscape, latest developments of INDs, and the companies that are majorly placed to be early entrants in the market. The major driving force behind the development of breakthrough NASH therapies is the unmet medical need for the condition. But there are a number of drugs currently in various phases of the clinical development pipeline, a few of which are set to enter the market within the next couple of years. The pipeline of the INDs for the treatment of NASH is dominated by small molecules currently. Although biologics are starting to make their presence felt, small molecules may prevail eventually owing to factors such as low manufacturing costs, the simplicity in the mechanism of action, and the ease in designing molecules against drug targets. In order to facilitate breakthrough therapies, there are some major challenges that need to be tackled by pharmaceutical companies. Challenges such as translation of clinical endpoint data from preclinical to clinical development, inadequacy of static 2D in vitro cell assays, and the currently employed preclinical animal models. Failures of INDs in the treatment of NASH over the years have been attributed to inadequate preclinical models, which have led to poor human translation in terms of drug safety and efficacy. All these have presented great opportunities wherein companies have started working on better predictive and translational models such as the organ on a chip, which can lead to better drug development outcomes, which in turn could help turn NASH into a more manageable condition within the next decade. On that note, I hope you have enjoyed this session. Please join us for future podcasts and become a member of Frost & Sullivan's Leadership Council by emailing us at digital@frost.com. Thank you for your time.